we now have the first vaccine to protect us against the virus approved in Canada. That is a remarkable story, a remarkable journey to see something that would normally take 10 or 15 years reach the finish line so quickly. One thing that people should be aware of, though, is that what this really is not a product of a lot of shortcuts, but more multitasking, where many, many of the steps that would normally stretch out the vaccine development and approval process have been telescoped so that the same steps could be achieved in a shorter time. Part of the speed relates back to all the technologies that were already in place to work on vaccines for other viruses. Various innovations have been chugging away in the background. People have been pursuing those innovations. New platforms like the RNA vaccines, like the one that was just approved, people have been working on those for other viruses, Zika, Ebola, even for cancer vaccines, which are challenging. And actually, that meant that in many places, people were well equipped to deal with the coronavirus, which is, as viruses go, fairly predictable, and also, more importantly, easy to target. It became very obvious right off the bat, almost as soon as the genetic code of the virus became available, that the target that was going to work was the spike protein, those protrusions that we see sticking out when we see pictures of the coronavirus. People sped their way through lab and animal testing and into clinical trials, partly by working on many candidates at once rather than sort of one at a time, and doing what was necessary to kind of get the information as fast as possible to get to the next step. But it still had to go through all the same levels of clinical trials, first to be checked for safety, then to see if there was any kind of an immune response generated by these vaccines, and then finally the phase 3 clinical trials, where the vaccine is tried with tens of thousands of individuals to look at the response. It was actually the misfortune of the pandemic that made the development of the vaccine so much faster than expected. And that's simply because the coronavirus was surging so much that it created a background of cases against which the power of the vaccine basically could be measured. At the same time, here in Canada, for example, these vaccines were applying for authorization under something that's called a rolling submission. So rather than assembling all of the data and having it all in a neat little package and then handing it over to the regulators, Health Canada was getting the data as it was coming in, so they could already start the approval process while the trials were still underway. And that's been key to getting to the approval now, where the approval in Canada has come just after the UK and even before the United States. So far, what we know from the clinical trials is the vaccine appears to be safe and effective. There are effects of the vaccine. No hugely adverse effects were in the trials, although now with the Pfizer vaccine, there have been a couple of allergic reactions that have turned up in the UK. Of course, there are mild and moderate reactions, as you would expect from a vaccine that is working and triggering your immune system. People who receive the vaccine, I think especially after the second dose, are liable to feel kind of sick and not well for a bit, as their immune system is essentially reacting to the emergence of viral proteins and then kind of learning how to deal with those. So that's normal for what would occur in this kind of thing. And it may actually, be a good indication that the vaccine is working. But of course, the long-term safety data is still unknown. This is something that's going to be monitored for at least 2 years as the vaccine carries on. What we don't know yet is how well it is at stopping the virus from spreading. That should come in another 3 to 6 months in the case of the Pfizer vaccine, and some of the others are also doing the same kind of data to just see if people who have the vaccine can still somehow acquire and pass on the virus without knowing it. What all of this means is that there are things about these vaccines that we don't know yet and that we can't know until more time has passed. But approval of vaccines is always based on the question of whether the benefits outweigh the risk. And in this case, the regulators have clearly seen, because of the toll that coronavirus has taken on human life and because of its broader effects on society, clearly in this case, it appears that the benefits outweigh the risks that we are aware of.